Thông trình cười. Ông rác bác cạp bản to sao nà cá. Xong chương lúc mì thúy. Nguồn chía bản to xùm nùa. Tại ông chúm rác xong lực đo lúc mì thúy tha. Lúc bàn bà bì bà lì ọ khai sấp nè tì hai. Nơi xoa xam sấp nè tì tiết xùm rạp bì krom bò lúc. Xong chương.
Good afternoon again.
So, chumrip sua lok sa sai.
I have some more questions that I would like
to put to you. Khmer mien samnua mo chumnun tiet da khnyom trai su lok no pe ni.
Completely different new subject.
Khnyom som chap dam neu pratean bat thmey mo tiet.
UWRI
no khnom kamnat 57639 robos lok
379 Khmer 001 0 7 7 7 7 7 7 7 7 7 7 7 7 7 7 7 7 7 7 7 7 7 7 7 7 7 7 7 7 7 7 7 7 7 7 7 7 7 7 7 7 7 7 7 7 7 7 7 7 7 7 7 7 7 7 7 7 7 7 7 7 7 7 7 7 7 7 7 7 7 7 7 7 7 7 7 7 7 7 7 7 7 7 7 7 7 7 7 7 7 7 7 7 7 7 7 7 7 7 7 7 7 7 7 7 7 7 7 7 7 7 7 7 7 7 7 7 7 7 7 7 7 7 7 7 7 7 7 7 7 7 7 7 7 7 7 7 7 7 7 7 7 7 7 7 7 7 7 7 7 7 7 7 7 7 7 7 7 7 7 7 7 7 7 7 7 7 7 7 7 7 7 7 7 7 7 7 7 7 7 7 7 7 7 7 7 7 7 7 7 7
Do you recall saying that to the investigators?
Do you remember what his name was? Do you remember
who the prisoner was? And do you know
what happened to the medic? Did he get punished? He was executed because of his involvement in the rape of this prisoner. Thank you. In your WRI,
so again,
Photographing to journalists, maybe Cuban, maybe Russian. Is that something you recall having testified to the investigators of the OCIJ?
ពីអ្នកដែលប៉ុនជំនួយមិនដឹងថាអង្គគួយបាមិនដឹងទៅឯងដែរប៉ុនថាកាន់នឹងមានដោយមកមានម៉ាស៊ីនថតមកគ្រឿងមិនដឹងកាន់បងតាក់ក៏នំហ្នឹងមានពីរហ្នឹងមានបងតាក់ក៏នំ
In your WI, you speak about it. Why did you have to examine that camera? Who gave you that instruction and why was that? Undoubtedly, this afternoon the prosecution will ask you about making photos of children. You, on that same page of your diary, you said that you never photographed any children. Is that correct? I understand. You were the main person responsible for developing the negatives of those photos. I realized that thousands of negatives were developed. But do you recall having seen children own those negatives? So while developing photos, photos of children, are you able to somehow attribute a percentage in terms of how many children you developed, how many negatives with children on it you developed in terms of the total amount of photos? Would it be possible that it would be between 1.5 and 2%?
Thank you, Mr. President.
I'm allowed to ask a leading question after having asked an open question first. But is it possible that your percentage of 10 would be a little bit higher than 1 or 2%?
ពួកគាត់ពួកម៉ាខ្ញុំឃើញអាការលៀងហ្នឹងថាផ្ដិតខ្ញុំម្ដាយបានហ្នឹងគាត់លៀងហើយទុកហ្នឹងបញ្ហាឃើញវាមកតាមហឹកឃើញមិនមិនឲ្យមកដល់មួយហ្នឹងមែនបញ្ហាឲ្យលុះលុះទៅទៅហប់ហប់ប៉ុណ្ណាហប់ហយហប់ពួក 20 30 ដាក់មែនណា
Do you recall ever seeing these children back at Praesar when you were there? Thank you. Now let me move on you've also mentioned in your WIs one or two times the number two And what is it that you can recall about him?
Jam away khlas tae tong chmuh ho ni.
Oh, ka nau anang nau knong tho 21 ho ke khang anupathien. Nau ra ni. Hai ho nong kwat khok phnek ko khang. Ban ya pe da pe pe yui mai chol ho ta phnom ku pi nyat khau khau khnie ke. Và tam hồn kết mới thì hồi gồm sâu cực cam được mà gì ta đòi về hạt bay ông về trôi là thả hạt nơi cao cục cột như một tiết đó.
Do you know anything about the division of tasks and responsibilities between Greek on the one hand and Hoa on the other hand?
Tại tôi đang đứng đối với năng Hoa nó thế.
Let me read to you a few excerpts from Duch's testimony about the division of tasks and responsibilities, excuse me, between him and Hoa. I will read two or three or four short quotes that he all confirmed a few months ago in this courtroom. Let me make it a little bit understandable. First, read the quotes, and then I will give you all the excerpts. Duke said about Hoa that quote, I only took personal charge of important detainees. For the others, it was Hoa who took charge of the details. Hoa took care of the Phnom Penh sector in every field, interrogation, as well as document reading. Anything that happened in the Phnom Penh sector would go through Hoa before it would reach him. He managed all the daily activities of S21. He was always occupied. That was the truth. For simple combatants, Hoa controlled everything and put order to torture. Now again, I will give you all the places where you can read those quotes.
Mr. Witness, before I do this,
can you give me a reaction? Is that an accurate description of the division of tasks between Ho and Duch?
Yes, I don't understand waiting until after the witnesses answer the question.
The reason for providing the ERNs and references is so that the rest of us in the courtroom can catch up. So I'd ask that you do that before the witness answers the question.
It's just a lot of numbers, little time, and
Just checking the numbers.
All right.
English 001 5 3 5 3 5 3 5 3 5 3 5 3 5 3 5 3 5 3 5 3 5 3 5 3 5 3 5 3 5 3 5 3 5 3 5 3 5 3 5 3 5 3 5 3 5 3 5 3 5 3 5 3 5 3 5 3 5 3 5 3 5 3 5 3 5 3 5 3 5 3 5 3 5 3 5 3 5 3 5 3 5 3 5 3 5 3 5 3 5 3 5 3 5 3 5 3 5 3 5 3 5 3 5 3 5 3 5 3 5 3 5 3 5 3 5 3 5 3 5 3 5 3 5 3 5 3 5 3 5 3 5 3 5 3 5 3 5 3 5 3 5 3 5 3 5 3 5 3 5 3 5 3 5 3 5 3 5 3 5 3 5 3 5 3 5 3 5 3 5 3 5 3 5 3 5 3 5 3 5 3 5 3 5 3 5 3 5 3
ួលដល់អ្នកបកប្រែ
The second
នៅយេប្រជាប្រមាណខែមុននេះនៅក្នុងតឡាការនេះថាហើយនៅពេលដែលមានការអានសម្រាប់ឲ្យដូចគាត់អះអាងប៉ុន្តែយ៉ាងណាក៏ដោយខ្ញុំគិតថាលោកប្រហែលជាចាំនៅអ្វីដែលខ្ញុំអានគឺតាក់ទងទៅនឹងការ
ដូចសេង
ថាគាត់ទៅនឹងដូចនិយាយថាហូគាត់ទទួលខុសត្រូវតើលើអ្នកទោសដែលមិនសូវសំខាន់ហើយគាត់ចាត់ចែងលើការងារប្រចាំថ្ងៃក្នុងផ្នែកតំបន់ភ្នំពេញហើយនឹងយុទ្ធជនសាមញ្ញធម្មតាធម្មតាតើវាត្រឹមត្រូវទេឬមិនក៏លោកយល់ឬក៏លោកមានព័ត៌មានផ្សេងពីនេះ
អូនឹងខ្ញុំក្តាប់អត់ជុំដែរពួកខ្ញុំអត់បានហ្នឹងដឹងលើពីខាងគាត់អនុហ្នឹងប្រធានហ្នឹងបានបានក៏ឡមកឃើញថាខាងនេះគាត់ក៏ដូចជាបដិសាទៅចាក់កងជាមួយកោហ្នឹងមិនគាត់ទៀតចាំយមិនព្រោះខ្ញុំដឹងថាប្រមុខនិញខ្ញុំនៅថតផ្ដិត
Fair enough no problem
មិនអីទេលោកសាក់សៃ
Let me move to my next subject.
ខ្ញុំបន្តទៅប្រធានបទថ្មីមួយទៀតលោកបាននិយាយអំពីកម្មាភិបាលម្នាក់ទៀតដែលធ្វើការនៅស21ឈ្មោះស្រី
Do you remember a person named Sri?
តើលោកចាំឈ្មោះស្រី
ស្រី
ឈ្មោះស្រីខ្ញុំមិនច្បាស់ថាស្រីឬក៏ស្រីទេ
ពោះមកស្រីគឺជាកបជនខាងការមើលការត្រូវអ្នកធំធំមានការអ្នកធំធំដល់ហើយតាំងការគាត់ចាប់ដើមក៏ដូចឲ្យមកធំម៉ាស៊ីនថតហើយម៉ាស៊ីនផ្ដិតក៏ដាស់ហើយព្រមក៏ឲ្យទៅដល់ទៅប៉ុណ្ណា
So was he needing those cameras for his tasks in relation to the important prisoners?
សម្រាប់ភារកិច្ចរបស់គាត់តើតើនៅអ្នកទោសសំខាន់សំខាន់ដែរទេ
អូកន្លងមកខ្ញុំអ្នកថតផ្ដាច់ដល់ខាខោនេះមិនដឹងម៉េចគឺមានអ្នកនេះយកឲ្យគីមកសុំប្រដាប់ថតប្រដាប់ផ្ដាច់អីជួយកណ្ដាលខ្ញុំដាក់បញ្ជូនឲ្យយកឲ្យតើខ្ញុំដឹងថាគេតែមានព្រោះចាញ់អ្នកធំមកបានព្រោះខ្ញុំក៏ឡោមមិនដាច់ជួបថតអ្នកធំធំថតព្រោះខ្ញុំកាលនេះមិនតន់ចូលស្អីគេជន់ឡើយ
Is it your assumption that he was the one taking photos of the incoming important prisoners?
In other words, that he had your task
when it comes to photographing of the important prisoners?
In other words, that he had your
task when it comes to photographing of the important prisoners? In other words, that he had your
Did you or your two team members Song and Nit ever take photos of dead prisoners?
Thot rup neak tuh da slap teh.
Men pe kha ban ke vai ngop ai lang ke a hau thot teu. Men ke vai ngop phuom lai ngop da dok. Da dak da ngai kup khum khang a
I have some questions about that, but I will skip them because of time. What is it that you recall about taking those photos? Were they soldiers? Were they officers?
ជាមកណាត់ខ្លួនដូចអ្នកទូធម្មតាចឹងគេថាអ្នកទូធម្មតា
Were there ever instances that people who were not really Vietnamese soldiers
were forced to wear a Vietnamese
uniform, or did that never happen?
ខ្ញុំមិនដឹងណាស់ទេ
ខ្ញុំអត់ដែរដឹងណាស់ណា
Let me skip some other subjects as well, and let me ask you some final questions.
This morning,
you identified the house where you, Song, and Nit were living, and where you were using the dark room
to develop the negatives.
You said that house is close to Duke's house, about 50 or 70 meters northwest, street 348, excuse me. A house which is now known as the Beehive Radio Station, close by,
prisoners
who had arrived were assembled. Do you know any,
ទៅមើងប្រហែលខែ8ទៅរហូតកាយផ្ទះវាភ្លេចអស់ហើយវាខកដឹងតែផ្លូវលូទៅសុយឆ្លងព្រឹកទូសុយមែនកាលឥឡូវផ្ទះគឺផ្លែថ្មីអស់ហើយ
August, you mean August?
Look, Gepi Saiha, Saiha Chanam Nung, Kai Munung Mente.
Mời lên nắng ngầm tầm mưa tao đâu về phải o cả về nắng phải hỏi
Indeed, but my question was when you went to the Beehive radio station in
3360,
was that in August of this year? So last month?
I was in August of this year.
That's very interesting.
Did you in August also visit the house where so many were staying?
I see, with great regret, Mr. President,
that I have finished my hour. ពាក់ព័ន្ធនឹងការកោះហៅសាក់សីដែលមានរហស្សនាម PTCW 1065 ដែលបានផ្ដល់ចម្លើយនៅក្នុងឯកសារ E3 ដែលមានរហស្សនាម PTCW 1065 ពាក់ព័ន្ធនឹងអង្គហេតុស្ថានភាពនៃចំនួនបដាវុធហើយអញ្ជើញអភិគីធ្វើការកត់សម្គាល់ទៅលើបញ្ហានេះនៅពេលនេះអង្គញាសូមប្រតិបត្តិការទៅតំណាងសាភិញ្ញាក្នុងការធ្វើការកត់សម្គាល់មុនពីទីដទៃទៀតសូមអញ្ជើញលោកប្រិញ្ញា
Yes, thank you, Mr. President. We took a look at the WRI's witness, and in our view, it seems to be a significant witness, position on which he can speak to a number of issues, not only the armed conflict, but also the purges in the East Zone, what exactly took place in that region. So our view was that this was a good witness to select and that he should be called to speak here.
Merci, Monsieur le Président. Nous en rapportons à l'appréciation de la Chambre.
With your leave, Mr. President, I believe the Kyusan Pan team has quite strong feelings about this, so with your leave, they will go first, and then afterwards we will go.
Merci, Monsieur le Président, de me donner la parole.
Je dois dire que nous arrivons à un stade où, puisque nous sommes amenés à faire des observations sur cette décision de faire venir ce témoin TCW 1065 Kokniomutu de la Chambre, nous arrivons à un moment où nous avons écouté de la défense de que son point un profond malaise. Et j'explique pourquoi. Et quand je dis profond malaise, c'est parce que j'essaye de trouver la formule juste à ce stade des débats. Un petit historique sans cause sur ce témoin en particulier. Le 22 mars 2016, soit à peu près il y a 6 mois, à peu près, 3 PV ont été communiqués par l'accusation dans le cadre de la, des obligations de communication dites à décharge. Je mets bien à décharge en, entre guillemets. Ça fait la, ça faisait suite à la décision que vous avez rendue dans cette affaire sur lesquelles il y avait une limitation des communications. Pas plus tard que le 4 août dernier, nous avons eu ce débat sur la question du statut de ces éléments qui étaient communiqués. Et lorsque, du côté de la défense de Constantin, nous avions indiqué que nous estimions que nous devions pouvoir répondre, au moins savoir si les communications répondaient aux critères qui avaient été fixés par la Chambre sur ce qui devait être communiqué comme étant à décharge. Il avait été répondu par la Chambre, par le biais de M. le juge Lavergne, qu'il n'y avait pas de préjudice, puisque ces documents étaient dans le share drive matériel et que ce n'était pas des éléments qui étaient versés au dossier. À l'époque, je recherchais le nom du témoin que j'ai retrouvé depuis. La Chambre avait proprio mutu également sur des communications qui avaient été faites d'éléments des dossiers 3 et 4 par l'accusation. La Chambre avait proprio mutu aussi décidé d'appeler Mulvaney. Nous sommes dans le même cas de figure, à savoir qu'il y a 6 mois, des communications, entre guillemets, à décharge, ont été faites par l'accusation, ni l'accusation, qui semble aujourd'hui changer de son de cloche, ni les, l'avocat des accusés n'ont estimé que c'était des éléments qui étaient...
Okay. I think the English translation is a little
bit. Je vais essayer d'aller plus lentement. Donc, de la même façon que pour Mulvaney, nous retrouvons avec un témoin qui avait été identifié normalement à décharge par l'accusation et c'est pour ça qu'il nous aurait communiqué les PV de ce témoin, que ni eux n'avaient jugé utile de faire de 87.4 ni pour rentrer les déclarations de ce témoin en preuve, ni pour l'appeler comme témoin. Aujourd'hui, je constate donc qu'il y a un changement de son cloche du côté de l'accusation. Mais nous qui étions censés trouver ça à décharge, aucune équipe de défense n'a estimé que c'était utile de le faire venir. La Chambre décide, en tout cas à l'air, de vouloir le faire venir. Donc, seulement, là, nous arrivons à un stade particulier de la procédure. Par une décision du 30 juin 2016, enfin en tout cas une liste du 30 juin 2016, la Chambre, qui avait donc eu également ces 3 PV depuis mars 2016, la Chambre n'avait pas jugé utile de mettre ce témoin sur sa liste des gens qu'elle entendait entendre sur le segment du conflit armé. Ce n'est que le 13 septembre, il y a deux jours, que nous avons un mail nous indiquant que vous envisagez, proprio de faire venir ce témoin sur la base d'un document E319/43.9-11, qui est donc le document de communication dont la Chambre avait rappelé à l'audience de mise en état que ce n'était pas des éléments qui étaient versés au dossier. Donc la Chambre va chercher des éléments qui sont extérieurs au dossier, qui viennent des instructions 3 et 4, qu'aucune des parties n'avait demandé, et nous sommes aujourd'hui le 15 septembre 2016, à quelques semaines de la fin de ce procès. Alors, la première observation que j'ai, puisqu'on nous demande du côté de la Défense, nos observations passent à cette décision qu'envisage de prendre la Chambre, si cette décision n'est pas déjà prise. Eh bien, la première observation que nous avons du côté de l'équipe du Que s'en pense, c'est de dire que nous avons un vrai problème d'insécurité juridique dans ce procès. C'est-à-dire que au 15 septembre 2016, alors qu'il y a eu une instruction qui s'est déroulée pendant presque 3 ans, nous avons une ordonnance de clôture depuis 2010, nous sommes en 2016 et nous annonce un témoin qui n'avait demandé, été demandé par personne. Alors, qu'on soit bien clair, j'entends bien que les règles de cette chambre permettent l'introduction d'éléments nouveaux si on estime que c'est utile et fondamental. Et on peut effectivement, et c'est le principe des 87.4, etc., introduire des éléments nouveaux. Mais n'oublions pas quand même que nous sommes devant une juridiction où il y a eu une instruction. Et n'oublions pas que cet élément nouveau vient d'une communication qui n'était pas censée être au dossier, puisque c'est ce que vous avez rappelé à l'évidence du mise en état. Et n'oublions pas non plus que nous sommes le 15 septembre 2016. Alors la Chambre rouge a pu introduire des éléments nouveaux, mais la manière dont ces éléments nouveaux sont entrés depuis ces derniers mois systématiquement dans le cadre de notre procès pose problème. Nous pouvons faire à l'issue de la preuve le petit pourcentage de ce qui était des témoins et des documents qui étaient dans le procès 02-2 et le pourcentage de ce qui est venu des autres instructions et le quantum est absolument affolant. Alors j'entends bien qu'il y a possibilité d'avoir des éléments nouveaux. Mais je rappelle, là je suis obligé de chercher sur mon ordinateur parce que je n'avais pas eu le temps d'imprimer, un petit retour en arrière. Dans votre décision, vous fixez au 1er septembre les derniers 84 que l'accusation doit pouvoir faire dans le cadre de ce procès. Vous dites, et c'est votre décision, E319-47-3, et ce paragraphe 23 que je suis obligé de citer en anglais parce que je n'ai pas de traduction française. Voilà ce que vous dites, c'est vous qui le dites. In any case, as the chamber approaches the close of evidence in case 02/2, there must come a point when the parties can rely upon the evidentiary record that has been established throughout the investigation and trials in this case. The value that additional evidence may have in ascertaining the truth must be weighed against the uncertainty created by allowing the admission of large amounts of new evidence near the close of the proceedings when other parties may not have sufficient opportunity to assess and respond to this information. C'est ce que vous dites. Donc aujourd'hui, moi ce que je constate, c'est que ce que vous avez dit en juin 2016, en faisant vraiment, il faut faire attention à la preuve qu'on amène. Nous, quand nous avons eu cette décision, on se disait, enfin, ce que nous dénoncions depuis le début de ces admissions en preuve en masse de documents qui ne viennent pas de l'instruction 02-2, qui viennent d'instructions extérieures sur lesquelles nous n'avons aucune prise. Enfin, nous nous disions, la Chambre a compris le problème que nous soulevons. Et là, je constate qu'aujourd'hui, non seulement la Chambre n'a pas compris, mais qu'elle contribue encore plus à cette incertitude juridique, puisqu'elle nous demande, à quelques semaines, encore une fois, de la fin du procès, d'entendre un témoin qui n'avait été demandé par personne, alors que depuis mars 2016, un témoin qui n'avait été demandé par personne, alors que depuis mars 2016, puisque c'est la Chambre qui nous a mis la décision, la Chambre en avait connaissance, les coprocureurs qui ont fait cette communication en avaient connaissance, ils n'ont pas voulu faire en 1984. Et les parties du côté des activés, pour lesquels on communiquait ces éléments qui étaient censés être à décharge, non seulement ne pouvaient pas des éléments à décharge, mais n'ont plus demandé à ce que ni ce témoin comparaisse, ni que ces déclarations soient versées. Donc moi, voilà le contexte dans lequel j'interviens aujourd'hui. Voilà pourquoi je vous dis, si vous nous demandez nos observations, ben non, du côté de la défense depuis 100 ans, nous ne sommes pas pour appeler à ce stade-ci un témoin qui vient, alors qu'il y a d'autres témoins qui viennent de 0-2-2 qui parlent du conflit armé. Alors que nous avons demandé, nous, par exemple, du côté de la défense, le témoin TCE, 87, si je ne m'abuse. Récemment, nous avons encore une fois redemandé sa comparution et qu'a priori, il n'y a pas de demande. Mais des éléments de 02-2 sur lesquels les partis demandent une comparution, ça, on ne se prononce pas, mais on va chercher quelqu'un qui vient d'un profil complètement extérieur et qu'aucune des parties n'avait demandé auparavant. Là, moi, je pense que il y a un vrai malaise sur la manière dont le procès est mené et organisé par rapport à la préparation de la défense, par rapport aussi à ce que ça veut dire sur à quelle preuve on doit répondre et de quelle charge exacte en fonction d'une ordonnance de clôture, encore une fois, qui a été rendue depuis 2010, sur quelle pièce condense. Nous sommes dans cette difficulté du côté de la défense de Khmer. Alors oui, nous sommes dans cette situation et je peux pas vous dire que nous avons une grande illusion sur ce que vous allez rendre. Si vous nous demandez des observations, c'est que, en gros, la décision est déjà à moitié prise. Alors, si la décision est à moitié prise, maintenant, je ne peux que rappeler ce que nous estimons être un vrai problème de sécurité juridique. Ce que nous estimons être une introduction plus que tardive d'éléments extérieurs au procès 02-2 au départ. Et nous demandons, si la Chambre doit appeler ce témoin encore une fois, un choix qui nous sera à ce moment-là imposé, eh bien nous demandons d'avoir la possibilité, la faculté, du temps pour préparer ce témoin. Et quand je dis du temps, je suis obligée, parce que nous sommes en ordre public, de rappeler que c'est important de rappeler dans quelles conditions nous travaillons chaque jour, dans quelles conditions nous devons à chaque fois nous adapter, comment il faut réorganiser le travail, comment les plans ne tiennent jamais parce qu'on a donné tel travail à telle partie avec des consultants qui sont en nombre limité. Et bien, quand vous introduisez de la preuve nouvelle, ça veut dire une nouvelle préparation, ça veut dire que ce qui n'avait été organisé, et bien c'est désorganisé, et ça veut dire que ce temps-là qui nous permettait, qui aurait dû normalement nous permettre de travailler sur les conclusions finales, par exemple, et bien c'est un temps qu'on est obligé d'utiliser à nous réadapter chaque jour sur la preuve nouvelle. Ce n'est pas normal, ce n'est encore moins normal dans le cadre d'un procès où il y a une instruction, et c'est d'autant moins normal le 15 septembre 2017. Si vous entendez appeler ce témoin, et je pense que la décision est déjà prise, c'est une nouvelle, mais non seulement du temps pour le préparer, en plus, et ça je renvoie à la dernière requête que nous avons déposée, nous voulons les audios qui sous-tendent ce PV, puisque c'est aussi un moyen de contrôler la fiabilité, la crédibilité du témoin. Et également, puisque on est dans un renouvellement incessant de la preuve dans ce dossier, que l'on puisse savoir une fois pour toutes, est-ce que c'est le dernier témoin que l'on va nous amener de façon surprise sur la liste des témoins qui doivent comparaître dans le procès 02-2. Je terminerai en disant ce sont des éléments que je tiens à rappeler parce que c'est quelque chose que nous dénonçons depuis le début de l'introduction massive en preuve de ces éléments qui viennent du procès 3-4. Nous préparons le procès en même temps que nous faisons le procès. C'est-à-dire que l'instruction qui est la base de la préparation de ce procès, elle se fait en même temps que le procès 02-2. J'aurais beaucoup de choses à dire, mais je sais que le temps est compté, donc je m'arrêterai là. Simplement, si la Chambre entend faire venir ce nouveau témoin, alors, encore une fois, qu'il n'était des autres parties, parce que le procureur le connaît depuis 2012. Mais si la Chambre entend, il nous faut le temps pour préparer les audios qui correspondent et que la Chambre tire les conséquences de cette introduction massive de preuves nouvelles lorsqu'il s'agira de discuter des conditions dans lesquelles nous allons faire nos conclusions finales. C'était un point que je tenais à marquer vraiment de façon importante et symbolique, parce que là,
I believe it might be useful to give a bit of context in respect of who this witness was or is whom we're talking about. A distant, rather distant family member. As the chamber is aware, we have a different position as to calling witnesses from cases 3 or 4. We have frequently asked ourselves for witnesses. So there is no problem in this particular person coming. We don't believe so. We have read his WRI, and he is not really, it seems, to be in any position to give answers to some very crucial developments and events in the East Zone in May 78 and before. He is apparently, in the view of the chamber, someone who is going to be testifying about the armed conflict. I'm not quite sure whether he could also testify about the topic of purges in the East Zone that I'm not sure about, but I suspect he can. But the bigger problem, of course, is that he is, to put it colloquially, completely small fries compared to the people that are really important
and who should come to testify in this courtroom.
If it's all right with you, Mr. President, let me refer to the chamber to one or two very interesting paragraphs of a minority opinion who we believe one of the most important and respectable judges in the field of international criminal law. The Belgian judge said in her minority opinion in the Katanga case, she thinks about the problem of missing evidence and missing evidence case, as we all know, something of crucial importance. She says in paragraph 148 of the minority opinion, and I quote, "The complete absence of evidence from those who were really at the center of things at the time inevitably creates the impression that essential information is missing from the record. Conclusions reached on the basis of such
incomplete evidence are inherently fragile and uncertain and cannot suffice for the standard of proof beyond reasonable doubt. On so many occasions, we have requested this chamber to summon the most important witnesses in this case, the most important witnesses in relation to the events in the East Zone, in relation to the armed conflict. We've asked many, many times to this chamber to call Heng Samrin, to call Prime Minister Hun Sen, to call Ubuntu, to call Bolson, to call Pan Sovan. They are the ones who are really important when it comes to giving evidence about the events that we are speaking about today, yesterday, and
the past 9 years.
So now,
asking
submissions on this nephew of Sao Pim, I'm happy if he comes. If he doesn't come, it's fine too. What really is important, Mr. President, is that the witnesses that I just mentioned are coming to the courtroom and give evidence.
We met Gisele,
thank you, Mr. President. I was brief because I'm rather surprised at what I've heard from across the aisle here, so let me respond to some of the incredible things we've just heard. First, that this person is not significant. You just heard a complete misstatement of this person's positions. He was not a medic in a hospital. He was the chairman of the regiment hospital. And on the 25th of May, 1978, when all the other leading cadres in this zone were purged, he was promoted to regiment commander. So I cannot, for the life of me, understand someone saying this is not a significant person. His interviews speak for himself, which is what caught the eye of the trial chamber. He complained about these interviews being disclosed. They were disclosed because they relate to and talk about various people in the East Zone who the defense have said they are a key part of what they are interested in this case. That's why they were disclosed. I'm not surprised that the new chain of defense would agree to this person being called. They're using it as an opportunity to bring up another issue, which I don't want to be drawn into at any point now, since it's not the issue Your Honors are deciding. And most importantly, the notion that this court chiding this chamber because it has the nerve to suggest and want to hear a witness is remarkable to me. This is an investigative trial chamber.
This is a search for the truth. If your honors think this witness will help you in ascertaining the truth, the witness should be called. These vague procedural objections we constantly hear from the Kisapan team are trivial. There can certainly be enough time for people to prepare. We're talking about one witness here with a few not that long interviews. So certainly, this is not a scenario in which you are calling someone to appear tomorrow. That would be prejudice. I'm sure you're going to give the parties ample time to prepare should you determine to hear from this person. Your honors have a duty here not to box yourself into an investigation that was conducted quite a few years ago, but to take advantage where new significant witnesses have come up. And if you feel that this person will help you ascertain the truth, then it looks to us like it is someone that can do that. The witness should be called.
Okun Ubrinya. Ong Jumriya Sum Okun Dol Pieki De Ban Thu Ka Kot. Sum Chi Lung.
Oui, merci, Monsieur le Président. Simplement pour deux observations pour répondre à l'accusation. Premièrement, s'ils estimaient que ce témoin était si important, vous avez la possibilité de faire une 87 et de demander sa comparution. Ils ne l'ont pas fait. Donc, à croire que du côté de l'accusation, en tout cas, ce n'était pas si important. Et deuxièmement, ce que j'ai dit aujourd'hui, et que je répète depuis un bon moment, n'est absolument pas nouveau. Mais ce qui est nouveau aujourd'hui, c'est que nous sommes le
15 septembre 2016.
Thank you, Mr. President. Good afternoon, Mr. Witness. I want to start just with some quick follow-up on your background before being assigned to S-21. You testified that you were initially assigned to be a photographer while you were in Division 703. What I don't understand is what was the purpose of people being photographers in a military division like 703. What is it that you were assigned to photograph while you were in Division 703?
កងតបចំណុះឲ្យកងពល703នោះហេតុអ្វីបានជាគេចាត់តាំងឲ្យលោកធ្វើជាអ្នកថតរូប
ឥឡូវខ្ញុំសូមនិយាយលម្អិតបន្តិចនឹងបញ្ហាហ្នឹងគឺកាន់មុនដំបូងគឺខ្ញុំជាជនអ្នកដឹកការទេតែរបួសហើយដូចពេទ្យពេលតែចេញពីពេទ្យខឹងកាន់ខឹងពេទ្យរឿងបែងចែកវណ្ណៈហ្នឹងបែងចែកបាក់ពួកហ្នឹងខ្ញុំក៏ប្រឆាំងគេក៏ខ្ញុំចេញប្រឆាំងដល់ផ្អើលថៃមឿនហៅប្រិទ្ធហ្នឹងព្រោះគេបែងចែកវណ្ណៈកង5កង100កង100គេហៅមកបាយម្លោសិតមហោមឆាញ់ឆាញ់តាមអ្នកយុវជនគេឲ្យស៊ីម្លោតាមគូតាមចេកឲ្យសាទៀតដល់ហើយក៏ខ្ញុំព្រះកាយខ្ញុំដើររួចខ្ញុំដើរចូលទៅហូបបាយឡើងចុងរួមគ្នាហ្នឹងក៏ពេលនោះក៏អ្នកដែលតែបួនថាម្លោសាទុំបើទុំបើពេលគេថាគេអត់ចេញមកក៏ម្នាក់ទេពីរទេខ្ញុំក៏ចូលមកហើយមិនថាមិត្តទាំងអស់សិតពួកបាយ3ឆៃបានមកត្រូវបួសហ្នឹងបានពេលបាក់ហ្នឹងអ្នកបងខាងពីតុកមួយហ្នឹងបានវាយរំដោះទេជាតិបាក់គេពុតគង់ men thay hoi men mòn chao nè qua phải nó ai mà về hộp bài mà đi pet nhang đây đó ba hai kia cùng luôn hai kia mà mong gọi má ban khơi thầy mới thầy mới hai cái đất nắng còn mở đó là mở đó ở khi xa có hai nhóm gặp trả là chỉ chỗ đất nắng còn cả thằng này mới ai bị giặt ngó á tầm số chả năm làm sao nhóm có về được còn phải thấy còn đang cuốn còn biển ngay biển mà chạy nam thở thì chạy hồi xong nằm đi bán này tàu biển phật nắng ngày đá đẹp biển chạy như sài á ở trong tàu buôn toàn kia pháo trong tàu buộc ruột nữa còn nhóm lọc mỏ chạy ngày nắng bay từ ngày nắng rồi bán còn thầm mò tới chuồng quạt đừng là khai cái ná đó gọi nhầm hai ở nhà xa hai con trâu tới cái thằng cầm ăn tay chui thừ đi phòng chui chặt một tô chặt ra để cái vai trình nhá tuân vai trình nhá lại cái cụ thế này đừng nói trộm đừng nói bao quả bay bay ngọt đọc thì chặt cả ghế bằng còn hai vô nhóm tư lại cái nát bàn cái nát ơi cái trâu lại thừ chuyện thọt sọ phi mùi rồi à rồi chuyện thọt bay rồi chặt thằng đó
I understand that it was because you were injured.
Sao bệnh nhà trầm trâu hay lốc nhầm dư lại lốc trâu rục bố hay lốc tôi sắp đặt bệnh nâng
à vậy để nhầm mình dư lên nhé
thà ta hãy đã vậy bán chỉ con pol bầm pol rồi bay trâu can nét thọt rù xem lục nhầm chết thế chẳng thật hãy đấy bán chỉ cái oi lốc thôi chỉ nét thọt rù bị chạm con pol bầm pol rồi bay
nhiều mất bàn đằng đại phần hà thom lại khởi bước về khởi miền khởi mình sinh thọt chán sắp đặt thọt chán đại đại ca thọt ca này khởi bước miền tây từ mỏ phun nai ná về miền bàn thọt những ai xa tốt á
Did you ever take any photographs before you were assigned to S21?
ធ្លាប់ចេះថតរូបអីដែរទេមុននឹងគេចាត់តាំងលោកឲ្យមកធ្វើជាអ្នកថតរូបនៅសរ២១ពេលនោះខ្ញុំអត់ទាន់ចេះទាំងអស់បានដល់ហើយគេប្រកាសបានមានតែមួយអ្នកដូចខ្ញុំប្រាប់ហ្នឹងដល់ហើយគេទៅហឺជឺហឺ៣អ្នកតែយិនចិនចំណែកខ្ញុំនៅ៣អ្នកក៏ខ្ញុំយកដើរមើលការចាត់តាមចិនអ្នកថតមើលតាមឯកសារ nhưng mà chơi phía xa nhầm chọc màu là ba mũ than xoay ổn nhà chơi phía xa nó bỏ phải chơi phía xa mai của mình thân thở lên thở lên thân nằm mấy thở thơ mấy mấy rồi nó mau bỏ phải chơi phía xa mai làm mấy gì lên chạy dành hai cán ăn cả bộ cả đa bộ thuy lúc chẳng khôi của má nó phải ra nó ở hạt chơi
Well, let me ask you something about your training as a photographer. This is what you told me.
ta dùm khán được ca phát đất lên ngủ thọ thì ta dùm cho ai ở xa để bị bỏ trả lại chuyện thọ để bị thì họ tâm bài cái hắn họ tâm cái kia tâm chân bó nắng dùm cho ai sáng tam xoay hổ nhạy chạy đắng kia càng chạy kia nâng ai bỏ phải chứ phải xa không ai mình
And how did you find those people?
Sabrenya, choh lok chuop neak tang nuh dao riebiep na.
Chuop ka nang chuop dam riyak dai khom som mau tanat. Tanat nang ko thap chen jong kwang pol, kam neak no ko som chok yo ai ao kot mue phet prap khang prap chai ti thot nang ao yo tai som ko ao chok ta bok phae ao na bok phae.
And is that how you learned to develop from reading the manuals that came along with the cameras in the foreign language by having those translated for you? Is that the source of your information?
ยังตามทฤษฎีอันบทตามทฤษฎีจักเตะที่เหมาะไปน้องคือบ้านอันบทจากสไลด์มาปิดกอดแม่นตาเลยตาเลยทวีเตอร์ตาเลี้ยงทวีต่างเลยขนำเลี้ยงทวีเลยขนำดัดรูปนั้นคือตามการจัดสไลด์คือปิดกอดบ้านออกแม่น
Mr. President, I'm about to turn to a new subject. If you wish to break your grounds, if you need to respond. Mr. President, I'm about to turn to a
new subject. If you wish to break your grounds, if you need to respond.